is with us once again at Yaharina, today's site for the women's slalom. As you look up at the start house, you can see the visibility is down to just a few meters. As well as the fog, the wind is gusting, and couple that with a temperature reading of 11 degrees Fahrenheit, today is one of the coldest we've experienced. Not your ideal day for a slalom race. The fog does thin in certain areas of the approximately quarter-mile course, and it changes almost with each passing moment. But the racers are up at the top of the hill, and the word is the race will be run. Words of wisdom from the coach, my colleague Bobby Addy. The wind now being measured up at the top of the hill. I don't think the wind is strong enough to affect the event. Nevertheless, with the 11 degrees Fahrenheit, it will create quite a chill factor. Thousands of people have found their way up here from down in the valley, Sarajevo. A huge throng is gathered at the finish line. And now up at the top of the hill, all of the racers are there. And as you can see, the fog is definitely going to be a factor in this race. Fog, wind, cold, well, we race in anything. And this is Tamara McKinney. She has a great shot at a medal here, along with Kristen Cooper. Tamara has to be disappointed in her fourth place finish earlier in the week in the giant slalom. She, of course, was one of the favorites in that event. She did not get a medal there. She has another opportunity today. And, of course, you can see the ice is caked around her hat, and it is really chilly. And Cindy Nelson, the grand lady of our U.S. ski team for over a decade. She has her radio. She'll be working her part of the course, communicating with the other girls. And here she is, Debbie Armstrong. We're all so proud of her, the gold medalist in the women's giant slalom. And here's another winner on the World Cup circuit in slalom competition. The women have run 7 World Cup slaloms this year. She won a Verbier January the 22nd. She's also had a 5th and a 9th place. This is Annie Kronbitzer of Austria, and the Austrians are really sweating blood for a medal, Beats.
Well, she's a big girl, 5 feet 9, 150 pounds. She's not really all that good a technician, but on a relatively flat hill like this one, she'll really roll them, and she'll really charge. You know, the pressure is really on the Austrians, particularly on the Austrian coaches. They haven't won a medal here, and all of a sudden, they've got to try to bail it out. Friends of mine at the finish line say, you know, they're going to get fired if they don't do something.
And Kronbitzer had the fastest time up on the top. She replaced Quario up on the top. And will the course get faster, Bob, as more racers come down, and when will it start to deteriorate?
Well, I don't know that it'll really get all that much faster, but any deterioration could be a problem in the fog because you can't see all the little ruts.
That's Monica Hess's time on the left, and we've got a new leader. She's from Austria, Anna Kronbitzer. She's 20 years old, and she's a big one, Bob. 5'9 and 150, as you pointed out. She got down in good fashion. She is the leader, followed by Hess of Switzerland, and then Quarry's Kristen Cooper, and she is the last remaining American in this competition. Tamara McKinney has gone out. Here comes Cooper, Bob, and I know after that silver in the giant slalom, she has really got to be pumped up.
Well, she really wanted to win a gold medal in the giant slalom. She felt that she really blew it with a mistake she made, and she's out of the competition. Tough break for her.
Tamara McKinney has gone out, and now Kristen Cooper has gone out. We knew she'd come out attacking the course. That's the only style she has. She went for the whole bundle right there, and Kristen Cooper is now out of the competition. Look at it again.
It was one thing that we did know she was going to do today, and that was to go all out, either win or lose. And she was flying through the top part of the course, and all of a sudden, right here, she got on her inside ski. Split-second timing, and she missed it right there. She couldn't get back on her downhill ski. Really a tough break for her.
Second run of the women's slalom. Frank Gifford along with Bob Beatty. And as you can see, the fog is still with us. If anything, it's even more dense than it was for the first run of the slalom. Nevertheless, a large crowd is gathered for this deciding run of the women's slalom. And let's take a look at the leaderboard. As you can see, a surprise leader, as we have Erica Hess, perhaps the best slalom skier, way down in 10th position. But Christella Guigna of France, 21 years old, hadn't done much until this year for the French team, but she had a 6th place finish January the 23rd at Verbier. So she is the leader. And you can also see there are no Americans in the standings. Tamara McKinney and Kristen Cooper both disqualified. Both of them solid medal choices in this competition. McKinney had the fastest mid-time in the first run. Nevertheless, she went out, and Kristen Cooper didn't even make the midpoint. And we have the first racer in the start house. And just as in the giant slalom, they reverse the order, the top 5 finishers, and you're looking at Paoletta Magoni. She actually tied with Perrine Pallon of France, but she has the lowest starting number, so she'll be on the course first. Here she is, Bob.
Well, she's going to give it a pretty good run. I don't know, Frank, there are about 14 to 15,000 people here. I don't know what they're looking at, though. You can hardly see anything. The fog seems to be even worse than it was in the first run.
Magoni of Italy was 14 one-hundredths of a second out of first place, and of course, there are five races within that 1,400th of a second span.
What you really have here, Frank, is nearly a tie for first place. Any of these top five girls can win. So they're really going to have to attack.
You're looking at 20-year-old Paoletta Magdoni of Italy. Her best finish thus far this year, a sixth place finish. That's her running time. We haven't even picked her up yet. You can't barely discern the finish line there.
That's ridiculous, Frank. You can't. She went to the finish and we didn't even see her.
Yeah, didn't even see her come through. But, you know, we talked to Cindy Nelson, the U.S. ski team. She said the girls weren't terribly concerned about the course. The fog wasn't all that bad, she said. At least she had talked with Kristen Cooper and Tamara McKinney, who disqualified her. And now, top of the course. This might be the last gal that could not. Paoletta Magdoni out of first place. This was the first place leader, Christelle Gagnon of France, a 21-year-old youngster who really hadn't done much, almost lost his spot on the French team a couple of years ago.
Oh, Frank!
She's out of it.
She hooked a tip. You know, I was just about to say the story of this slalom were two unknown.
Bob, she doesn't know yet.
I think she just got the word.
There it is. Oh, and up go the skis.
And who congratulated her first? Great sport.
This is what it's all about. It really is. Not one of the great days for the U.S. with Tamara McKinney and Kristen Cooper disqualifying in the first run, but this is really the Olympics. An almost unknown, pixie-like 19-year-old Italian who has never won a major ski race or even come close. Standing at the finish line, sobbing tears of joy. And for the Italians, who are part of the throng at the finish line, they are also caught up in the emotion of a magical moment. For little Paoletta Magdoni, you've got to love her. She takes the gold, Karine Vallon of France the silver, her second medal. She was bronze in the GS. And Ursula Concert of Liechtenstein, she takes the bronze in the slalom.
And so Paoletta Magdoni, the 19-year-old daughter of a bricklayer from the little village of Salvino, Italy, had won the gold medal. Her dad couldn't afford to come here at first, but her grandmother treated him to the trip. It sure was worth it.